Coming up next on the Jeff Crilley Show, a new way of looking at retirement living. The story just ahead.
Many are predicting that the worst is yet to come, which is unfortunate, said one person here. Until now, they've enjoyed the reputation of being the nation's icebox.
Watched a burglar in his home this morning by webcam.
As a journalist of over 25 years, stories are what make my world turn.
Reporting live from the Dallas newsroom tonight, Jeff Crilley, Fox 4 News.
But in 2008, I took the jump from my familiar life and started a PR firm from my home.
We're talking about anyone with a camcorder like the one I'm using becomes a television network.
We started slowly growing the company, and we now have over 100 clients, and we've branched into the world of live digital broadcasting. I now own 8 different TV studios and have a huge team, and the stories that I now get to share are sometimes the most important of my life. Life has a funny way of coming around full circle. This is the Jeff Crilley Show.
So what do you think about when you think about retirement living? Do you think about somebody in a rocking chair knitting or playing shuffleboard or dominoes? Well, I'm sure that's out there too. But to look at a new way of retirement living, Aimee Barresi is in studio. She is with Presbyterian Village North. Thanks for coming on the show.
Oh, glad to be here.
Yeah. Okay, so tell us about Presbyterian Village North.
Well, it's a CCRC, which stands for a Continuous Care Retirement Community, and what it encompasses in our 66-acre beautiful community is every type of living that you can imagine when you're looking to retire and downsize your life for a simpler way of life. We have independent living for those who want to be totally independent and live life on their terms and what they want to do. Your next level would be assisted living, where you just need a little bit more care and help, and medical could be involved. And then our memory support is a community that's dedicated to those afflicted with Alzheimer's and dementia, with that special care and training. And then we have skilled nursing, if someone needs to come in and rehab, and also a wonderful outpatient rehabilitation.
Outstanding. You have very cool residents, residents like Tom.
I started writing about 10, 11 years ago. I lived in Reno, Nevada, and just getting ready to retire, and I needed to lose some weight. So I picked up a clunker bike I'd had for years in my garage, hadn't ridden it. So after about a year, 6 months maybe, I bought this one. And been on it since. Yeah, both my wife and I ride. We ride the trails on campus and on trails off campus. Typically my ride is an hour, 20 minutes, an hour and a half. And that's about 10 to 12 miles. The last few years we were in Reno, it was kind of getting lonely. We were in a big home, kids are gone. So we decided it was time to move near one of our three children. One was in Texas, so we moved to Texas. When we got here, looking it over about 4 years ago, and the first time we walked through, the grounds are perfect. People are friendly. I mean, Texans are friendly, but in this atmosphere, this is a very friendly community. We just have friends coming out our ears.
Very cool story. And you tell me that Tom inspires you as well.
Oh my goodness. So I was driving through the community and I saw Tom on his bicycle and it just hit me. I was thinking about a fundraiser, an idea of something different that I wanted to do for the longest day, which is a nonprofit that we support, the Alzheimer's Association. They do tremendous work. And on the 21st of June, the summer solstice is the longest day. And we take that day to raise awareness and also to raise money for the fight to end Alzheimer's, to find a cure. So I saw Tom riding his bike and I thought, what if we could do a triathlon? Because there's Tom with his bike. I saw other residents riding on their bikes. And we are set to open a $1.1 million walking trail.
Wow.
That was funded by our foundation, which is made up of residents at PVN. So it just all worked perfectly together to have a triathlon to celebrate and inspire
yes.
what residents can do and what people can still do in their 70s, 80s, 90s, and I mean, even into 100. We have someone who's over 100 years old, and it's just so inspiring.
And we've all been in places where you feel warmth or you feel cold, and you guys have a very warm and inviting look about you. We're going to show a home tour, and as we're showing this, I want you to kind of narrate it for me. What is it about, like, even the architecture, and what are you guys trying to do at Presbyterian Village North to make it feel like home?
In 2022, PVN was proud to win the Architectural Award from Senior Living News for our architect and our work in Corrigan. Corrigan, which you see in this opening clip, is actually the heart of Presbyterian Village North. It's where our dining venues are, our aquatic center, our 14,000 square foot gym. We have beautiful water areas with a lake. It's really funny because when I'm walking around with a resident or a prospective resident, I always say, cue the ducks. And then the little duck mamas and their little babies appear. And it's just a perfect park-like oasis.
Outstanding. You were telling me a story just before we went on about a resident that you met. Would you share that story?
Oh, yeah. It was a really, it was a funny story that turned out to be quite heartwarming. I was running around the campus, as I often do, being the community liaison. I have a lot of different places to be, and it is a big campus. And I heard a little voice say, come in here and sit down with me for a while and tell me about yourself. And I, you know, had that little moment of whether I could say, I'll come back, I'm too busy. But I said, you know what, I'm going to stop what I'm doing and visit with this resident. And it just wound up being so great. She wanted me to talk to her about myself, but I actually wound up learning a lot about her. I did her hair, I did her makeup, I helped her get her shoes on, and we went down to lunch together. And that really is what it's all about in senior living and what we get to do at PVN.
Well, and I can see why you're so excited. You told me something earlier about you giving your life in service. This is the happiest you've ever been.
It is. When you give yourself to someone else and you are serving, you wind up losing yourself. And it's almost like the ego just goes away because you are helping someone. I mean, our seniors are some of our most vulnerable. And what's really cool that's going to be happening this year in 2023 is PVN was awarded a $1 million grant from the Jeff Bezos Foundation to open up a Montessori school, a preschool on campus for underserved areas. So it's going to be totally free.
Wow.
Montessori, and it's going to integrate the two different stages of life, all the way at the beginning with the babies, and then our residents that are older and retired. And it has proven to be quite wonderful, and it helps both generations in so many ways. And they've done it in Canada, they've done it in Japan, and now it's coming right here to Dallas at PVN. We're excited about it.
And I can see why. I mean, for an older person, just even hearing the laughter of children in the neighborhood is just a wonderful thing. I also want to brag about you guys, and you do different holiday themes. I found a nice little video. Let's go ahead and roll it.
Girl, I'm about to show you off. I'm gonna do this for the grand. Introduce you to the fam. They show you love cause I'm the man. I'm gonna do this, baby. What's gonna do it? Yeah, I'm gonna do it. Ride, 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 oh baby. Anything you like, I got, oh baby. I wanna ride with you, I wanna roll with you. I wanna ride, 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 oh baby, yeah.
It looks like just such a fun place to work.
And such a fun place to live.
Yes.
I mean, they are constantly having parties. They go out to the symphony. They have speakers come in. They make art. I'm ready to retire.
All right, so we're almost out of time. So final thoughts and the next step, if somebody was watching this, do they call you for a tour or what happens?
Yes, if you would like to come and see our beautiful 66-acre campus and everything that it encompasses, we would would love to bring you on a tour. And the most important thing to think about when you're thinking about that next stage of life and downsizing, maybe you're an empty nester in a big house, is that you want to make the decision on your own terms to retire. You don't want it to be your age or an incident that happens, because then it's a stressful situation going into senior living. And if you come over and see us, you'll see that PVN, it's a place to live.
Wow.
Our residents are living their best lives and all their moments matter.
Outstanding. You've been a great guest. We're going to end with the website, which is forefrontliving.org. The great Aimee Barresi. Thanks for coming on the show.
Oh, loved it.
That's it for now. We'll see you next time.